Hello, good morning, community. Good evening. Welcome to the new PL Roundtable.
Hello,
good
guys.
Afternoon.
Hey, what's going on?
Hey, everyone.
Okay. All good, all good. And you? Okay, so let's start.
Welcome, guys. It's been another week. Happy to have you all here again. I guess that we start with the questions. Anything that you guys may want to know. It's been a rough week, and you know where the focus was. But if you have anything to ask, you know, now is the time, maybe, and a few things we may share after that. So please go on with the questions. Status on Cryptopia.
Okay, just a second. Okay, Cryptopia is going on. We are currently, we don't have number to share, to be honest, because we are waiting for them to share something. We wait for an official report and correctly done, so we can know where we go and what we have to do. So I hope during this week we will have something. Yeah, we don't control Cryptopia, by the way. It's a third party, and so we will do our best, and no one will lose a coin. And yeah, we still on the way the statement that we wait for them.
Yes, you're cutting a little bit, so for whoever couldn't hear you well, we're just waiting for their feedback on the audit, because we have the information on our side. We need their input as well. We already said in the first announcement that people's funds are safe, and we will do everything that we can to keep it that way. So this is about Cryptopia. We need to hear from them. Meanwhile, the guys are still working.
Oh, we have a new a new member.
Right.
Two new members.
Yeah.
Any other questions, guys? Well, Mickey should have bought them.
Yeah. Okay, it's already calm today. Wasn't expected. Maybe everyone is sleeping.
Don agrees, had a question longer up, further up.
Marketing campaign is currently up and running. By the way, we work on it. I have to tell that I was approached by some big TV show. We are currently negotiating a bit with them. I just shared that the information as I have it, but they want really a shit ton of money. So we will see if we can find some middle point for that. Yeah, we are not an ICO. So by the way, we don't have a shit ton of coin to spread in the nature.
Right now we have internal marketing plan in development. So we'll be looking forward to start on that really soon. We just had our first marketing meeting this week with the new guys. So we're moving in the right direction. We have a new
following
people forming around that.
For following that, I just want to please and welcome Miner Allen in the team, as he will be in charge of all the YouTube and PillTube thing. And we have also Wakul that is coming to reinforce the marketing ID and team. So welcome on board, guys.
Welcome, yes, guys. Welcome. Really happy to have you. And we have been together the last weeks, and it's really nice to have some fresh blood in the team with DP Telecom and Mickey and Alan and Raku now.
Yeah, welcome, guys. So,
yeah, we are forming into a good, nice group for reaction on marketing and everything. So it's always nice to have some fresh blood in the team and people that have new visions and new ideas, things that we can brainstorm and work together for the better future of Pyro. So welcome, guys, and I hope that we...
you will enjoy it. maybe if you have a microphone, you...
Optimistic Corn, about the Pyro company registration, we are still working on the documentation that that it's required.
Gotta dot the I's.
We have a legal partner, and they're guiding us through the process.
Yeah, it's like we said, we hope to book that for this year. You have to know that it's really painful, stressful, and money hungry, all that kind of process. So we do our best. We have to write a lot of documentation because it's crypto. Oh, we will handle all the thing.
Small bureaucracy as well, as everywhere.
Yeah, and as we don't just want to make a crypto company, we want the PL exchange with the fiat conversion. So yeah, we have to fix all that details in the same time. So when we have fixed it, all the thing, we can open what we want. That's the goal.
I have one question. It looks like
you are not allowed to ask question, Mikey.
Oh shit! Oh fuck my life! Okay, I will write it down. okay, guys, come on. So it looks like that we will want a hard voting for the decentralization action listing. I want to know your opinions, if you like it or not, because I think we have done all what was necessary. So guys, let me know if you are interested.
I must say my word about it first, and let's see the other guys. It's a very nice idea, but it's ICO, and you know that first we need to see it happen. But it's a great job that we did what we could, and we are one foot in. Thank you very much, Mikey, for that. Now all we need is for them to realize their vision and make it happen. And it will be great. Well, that's Mike Magic. He have been bothering people. You know, guys, even one night I'm just working and we have this website widget where we help people that have questions. And all of a sudden, a guy shows up writing in the chat. Hey, can you help with the exchange voting? And then I find out it's Mikey using the widget to ask the support agent for votes on the Hort exchange. So we must thank him for all these votes and all you guys. You have been great and you really spread this out. I heard about some people asking their grandmas to vote and so on. So this is the power of the community and thank you a lot about that. Look who do we see here? I'll leave that to Julian.
Yeah, I'm really pleased to have a guest today, Mr. Grodigy.
Hey, Grodigy.
Hello, 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 welcome.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Grodigy, what's up?
Legends are here.
I'm all right. Thank you very much for inviting me down today, guys.
We're very happy to have you. You are an old face for Piro. I remember you from the days that I were not yet in the team.
Thank you.
So yeah, we are really pleased to get you today. And yeah, maybe you can present a bit some reason why you are here and your project.
Of course, yeah. Thank you very much, guys, for having me on. I was having a quick chat with Master Dubs last week, just around our project, and Pearl is one of the teams that's kindly volunteered to kind of be reviewed as one of our promotional listings. So what would be nice just to kind of come and have a chat with the community, just to kind of get the wider message about what we're looking to do. So we finally managed to get our website launched last week, but originally the project came around because as you guys are aware, I'm a miner in crypto for a long time, and the last kind of 9 months has been really difficult for a lot of us miners, because it's just been really difficult picking out good proof of work projects and ones that stand out. So Pearl is one that came to mind for us. I remember kind of mining this when it came out this time around last year or earlier. The developing team has always been really open, very transparent, very honest, always willing to help their community. And so this is a prime example of the... You're welcome. And this is a prime example of the sort of coin we want to advertise on our platform. So the idea being that a miner can come on our website, they'll have a list of coins that have been reviewed. So that basically that review means that the developer team has contacted us to do the review, not the other way around. So the first thing it kind of gives the community is a sense that the developer is being proactive in kind of promoting his project elsewhere, and also being transparent in verifying his ID to some extent. So the basis of our reviews tend to revolve around three factors. So what we initially were thinking about was just reviewing the developer's identity as a confirmation that, you know, he's a solid dev and that he's kind of willing to put his name to the coin. After a while, we realized the kind of failure point with that is we may get people who'll still try and do the scams and put a fake name or fake ID to something. So there's still an element of a failure point with something like that. So we made it a little bit more stringent or a bit more diligent in the way we're doing the reviews. And that will kind of consist of the initial team verification. So what will happen is the lead developer on the team, say, for example, Master Dubs, he'll just come on our website. He will register. He'll tell us what tier of verification he wants, which basically varies from just providing basic info like first name, last name, telephone number, email. So these are things we can just verify with the developer, all the way up to Tier 3, which is basically at the highest level of verification, where they provide their government ID to our verification site. Our third party kind of handles all the verification, and then they just come back to us with a successful or declined message. So that's the initial step. And then after that, once we get the developer team or core developer verified, we then do a check on the code for the coin just to make sure that all the specifications in there match. There's no hidden pre-mines. And also just to kind of highlight any work that the development team might have undertaken, but that's not really acknowledged in just a general announcement when they say, oh, we worked on this and this is the update. From our point of view, we really want to reward developers and show developers that are working on their GitHub and updating their documentation and doing updates, just to kind of give a flavor of the work that goes on the back end that, you know, non-technical people may not see. And then the final part of our review is a fundamental review. So that's just a basic overview on what the coin does, what's the scope of the coin, what's its, you know, any niche in the market, any new technologies, what's the coin about in terms of distribution, what's the specifications for the coin, which exchanges it traded at, and any intangibles that may have come along. So has the coin had a rebrand, a takeover and team? So in a nutshell, the review we're looking to provide is just an objective overview of all the information on the coin where someone can get it at one source. We were very keen when we came out with the idea and developed the review that we stay objective. So the idea being, we don't want any developers to be put off from coming onto our platform and being verified if the community turn around and say, well, your rating was 1 out of 5, or, you know, other projects have got higher ratings. The whole kind of ethos I'm looking to build in the community for proof of review is for our users to kind of praise the developers who have come on board and hopefully kind of push for this to be some level of standard in crypto. So my main kind of goal would be is that maybe say 12 months time from now, that the developers who have been coming out and doing serial coins, they may still exist. We can't get rid of them. But what we can do is kind of vet them to a certain point.
Hey, it's Rhett.
Sorry.
Dango, you just killed all my questions. I think that what you're doing is great, especially with all the new people coming to crypto and all the new projects and them not having enough experience to identify which project is legit and which project is absolute scam.
Exactly.
I think that your idea is very noble. I think that's something very special and needed for the cryptosphere. Do you have any plans to elaborate this further? Like, for instance, something while I was listening to you, something that came to my mind was maybe specifying having a legal in your team and be able to specify which project is security and which is commodity and so on. You know that the Howley test was something very often used for this purpose. Do you have plans to implement such a categorization of the projects?
We don't, but I really like that idea. Thank you so much for that feedback. I think that's a very valid point, because even in the proof of work sector, we'll find that we will get a kind of differentiation between the coins, whether they're utilities, whether they're securities, whether they have any other function. So I think that's a very good point, buddy. And I think I will note this down for us to something to develop on some point down the future. I like the idea of maybe doing a Howey test within the crypto sector. So basically, just based on our experience, we can determine what kind of, you know, utility or kind of
security. Yeah, that's not only great for the people that will be looking at it, but also for the projects. If you have enough due diligence to perform it, and I'm sure that you can develop to the point where you can provide that. It's something great for the people to see and for the projects. Even I'm sure that there is a lot of projects that even on themselves, they cannot say if they're a security or commodity or whatever.
I agree. They probably don't know themselves, to be honest. They come out of an idea and it's only maybe somewhere down the line that someone with more expertise points it out. If you're giving dividends or something like that, for an example, you know, they may be classed as a security or something. So it's a very valid point. I don't think a lot of projects themselves know.
Yeah, yeah. It's very nice.
It's something we'll definitely add. And I mean, maybe just one last thing to touch on is, I know you've a few guys have mentioned in the chat about kind of making this as a standard. Our aim at some point will be is that, you know, someone can use our website as like a first point of resource or research to kind of gather all the information, the basic information about a coin, and then go from there. What I find right now with a lot of new coins that come out, and this tends to be the process for my research, is that the developer will launch the YAN. He can only put a limited amount of information on there. It's done in a certain format. And then what inevitably what we find is all the questions then move to the social media, and the developer's inundated on his Discord from his members with the same questions over and over again. So my vision is that we can eventually get this to the point where developers contact us before they want to launch a coin, then we can do the vetting before they're launched. We can kind of do some of the legwork for the community on their behalf, and then they can potentially launch. We can have like a new section on our platform where only the developers who have been verified and had their code checked can come on our site, be listed, and you guys as miners then don't have to sift through every new AN that comes out on Bitcoin Talk and then do your, you know, your research on every single project from there. So we're just hoping in time that this becomes an industry standard for you guys, where A, it saves you a lot of time, B, it gives you a bit of peace of mind to know that the developer team has been checked and verified, C, that you know that the developer is willing to come forward and put his name to the project, which is very important, I think, in the proof of work.
It sounds absolutely great. And I think that we needed this in the sphere for a long time, and it's great that someone is having enough experience and knowledge to do it, is handling it, and it will develop in this sphere.
Thank you. And I guess that kind of leads me on to the last point, is I've been really keen to build a solid team around this. So people who are well-known in crypto, got lots of experience, and tend to do this code review and fundamental analysis as part of their day job. I know it certainly kind of takes up the majority of my time when I'm looking for coins. So I guess on top of the service we offer, we also want to kind of give some reassurance to the developer community and the mining community that the people who are vetting these projects and doing the due diligence behind it are kind of guys in the sector who know exactly what we're looking for before you guys maybe even look for it, if you understand what I mean.
Yeah.
Yeah, people tend to believe medias a lot lately, and I think they don't realize that media you can buy, but something like your product, I guess you cannot buy. This is something that's absolutely.
Yeah, media is marketing. Marketing tell what you ask them to tell.
Exactly, yeah. And media, even mainstream media, you can buy anything. But you cannot buy due diligence.
It's very true. And I guess how we've tried to promote this to developers is that this is another way for you to be able to promote your project on a platform that's maybe not as competitive as Bitcoin Talk. But also, I know some developers, not kind of naming any names, I know it's kind of been especially prevalent in the ICO world. These guys will just pay people for the promotion without any sort of diligence or check on the project itself. And I kind of think when I'm talking to developers around this, yes, I understand you want to get promotion for your project, but by paying someone to talk about a cash tag on Twitter gives you absolutely no value to the end user, which is, you know, the guys who are looking to invest in these projects.
But there is a lot of people that fall for that, you know.
There is, unfortunately. Yeah, there is. I mean, I think people have got a little bit wiser in the last couple of months, but unfortunately, I think people tend to forget sometimes, and then as soon as you see a cash tag from a big name on Twitter that's kind of, you know, promoting a project, he may have been paid, he may not, he may disclose it, he may not. But I think from the guys in the industry, we've kind of learned now who is being paid and doesn't care, and who actually promotes a project because they like it. And then also the ones that there are guys who are doing similar things to us right now, but they're doing it on a very individual basis, where they're just doing fundamental analysis on a coin and just posting it on Twitter just for their own benefit. What we're looking to do is kind of offer developers that choice to come to us, we'll do it independently and it's objective as well. I think that's a key point, is we don't want to offer any financial advice for our reports. It's just a question of, you know, we offer the information for people to make an informed choice, but our unique selling point on top of that is that, you know, we use the third-party service to verify the developer's ID and the team, and also the fact that the developer's contacted us as a first point, as a first move, shows that he's the one willing to promote his project, not the other way around, rather than us just shilling what we've got and just saying to the community, yeah, we've done a review on it. You know, it's all developer-led in terms of the reviews we do. And on the flip side, all the reviews we do are community-led. So we're very keen on just providing this service as free of charge to the community so they can access it. And Dustbase has made a very good point. Yep, it's only natural for Pearl to be up for POR reviews. So I will have a quick chat with Master Dubs after the roundtable just to see where we're up to. I shall pass him our initial report, see where we're going, see where we're up to, just see anything that needs amending. But yeah, I can reassure you guys, Pearl is definitely on the list to be
put. Thank you very much, Grodigy, for coming here to share this with us. This is something great, and as you know, that Pearl has some ideas to bring ease of use and to bring honesty in crypto. We try to be absolutely transparent about everything and actually count on development and features that are easy to use and needed by the people. So thank you very much for showing here and accepting our invite.
Thank you very much for having me, and you know, it's kind of been really good for me to kind of meet up with you guys, to see the fantastic work you guys are doing. Again, I've not kind of kept up with the project for a few weeks, not seeing all the updates and stuff like that. So again, it's just a testament to you guys as a team. While a lot of other guys in crypto will kind of get distracted, and while price is not good, they give up. I think it's a real testament to you guys that you're not only working on the project, but you're kind of working harder than ever to deliver, you know, innovation in the space. And just a final point, I think what you mentioned about the dApps is a very, very valid point, and I'm really glad to see you guys are one of the first kind of pushing it for ease of use for the end user.
Thanks, Ben.
Thank you. I got maybe a point of an idea, because you mentioned it. A lot of people are paid to create review. We got lots that asking us to pay for a review, meet the user. Could be a good idea to have like a list of legit media on your website too, so where people can maybe find valid information.
Very good point. Yeah, because I mean, if you're selling our service as a first point of reference, I guess the guy would then maybe need some sort of guide to do his further research after that. So yeah, that's a valid point, and I think I will make a note of that. So thank you very much. I think that's a really, really good idea.
We're always open to share ideas, and you're always welcome to our meetings, of course, to check how we are going and what's up. And by mentioning that, you know that we have been under a 51% attack, and even through that, I think that it's nice that we already have an update on our first application. Julian will share more details about that.
Exactly. And I guess one final point is, although we do charge, I mean, we just have to, based on the fact that we've got costs, we've got overheads, to balance that out, to make sure we kind of offer this service to those that don't have any developer funds or pre-mines or anything, to not kind of isolate them. We are going to be offering potential for, if any coin's got a zero pre-mine, no ICO, no dev fee, you know, we will offer them the chance to be reviewed free of charge. So if you guys do have any projects that you know of, any personal coins that you like, you know, the devs working hard, you know, by all means, feel free to kind of refer them into us if they want to get a review done free of charge.
We'll do it, for sure.
Fantastic. Right, well, thank you so much for the time, guys. I don't want to take too much more time in your meeting. I will sit around for the rest of your meeting, and I will certainly be here every week from now on, because I think this is a really good way for developers to contact people. So again, I just commend you guys on being so kind of transparent and open with your community.
We just want to thank you for your great project too, and to be here.
Thank you,
GrowDigi.
Thank you so much, guys.
And developing some useful stuff for the cryptosphere, of course, because we just have too many projects that just show around and they want to bring something new, but it's always the same thing and the same thing over and over again. So it's great to have some projects that actually develop things that are useful for the people and avoid scams and so on.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Okay, so if we don't have any other questions, maybe it's time, Julian, to share something with you guys. We announced Raku and...
Yeah, we will also put the last version of PillTube live, where we made a lot of fix. I would like to thank you, Sis, for that. we will share the link, we will share the changelog, if I think DP Telecom already do it, so I just have to push the button and publish it, and we will push the new link, so you will be able to test it. Minor Helen, are you there? Maybe you can speak about the fix that was made?
He's recording, so he won't be able to talk to us. Yeah, because his environment is not set to speak and record at the same time.
Okay, so speak about it. I will let you do.
Me?
But yes.
Okay, so we basically have 90% of all the bugs and suggestions that were put through the button done. Everything is cleared out, and besides that, we also have some new features that you guys, I hope you guys will like. It was a suggestion by the community to have a guest view where people can watch videos without registering. We have improved upload, we have approved playback, we have added Greece language. You guys see the change log. There is really a lot done. I think that Minor Alan can share that because he is done with the internal testing just recently. Push the button. Yeah. So you can push the button and let the guys see everything in there. I think that you guys will like it, and I will be waiting for your new bugs and suggestions, as everything that was up to now is now fixed.
Yep.
We also have one more thing that we'll just just put in announcement, Julian.
I think we have a little dashboard, guys, that will help you. Hopefully, just checking before if we have nothing in a red line. It's simply a dashboard when you can see when all is green or when a service is disrupted. So you just go over it and you see it. You see if Poseidon is down, up, the website, GitLab, the docs, the master node system. So you have to make difference, and I spread it in the website. You have Poseidon, it's all the front ends thing, the dashboard and so on, and you have the Poseidon master node, that's for the back end, so where your master nodes and all the information and so on. So it's mainly that that you will be interested in.
Also, Optimistic Corn ask you, Julian, what's the status on our interview? I think month will be okay.
Yeah, I think month will be okay because, to be honest, our interview now is like you. We have not so much time, to be honest.
Come on, it's not that long. A few questions.
That's 500 rows of code that you write. So just let's push the priorities first. It will be nice to see the interview coming up with some of the releases.
Yeah, we will do it definitely, but we have more. I wonder, maybe the word is not the good one, but we have more important thing to do before. I think you will understand what I mean, because we have to fix this 51. We are good because we are able to split the chain, and the attacker now will be attacked in mostly. So the contract is up and running. George, maybe you can give an input about that.
Hey, guys.
Hey, George.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, George.
Yeah, we just moved on with Julian, and we already have commanded the 51 attack to be chain splitted, so the attacker just he will stay alone on his own chain, so won't have anything negative on the main chain. And this is going to be actually what I wanted to point out. This is going to be just a start for the new for the next months for Peril. Like, we're not going to just push code that is actually fixing the chain. We're going to push code that is actually making it better. So you can expect all the things. As soon as we finish with this one, you can expect all the things that we were normally working on to be continued. And I'm really I really believe that the next 2 weeks, the solution will be out there and running on the Peril chain.
Yeah, the goal is to put it live in 2 weeks, because we need it also. We want it before reopening the exchange and so on. So we are free and we are really confident with that, and we have a good mind to work on those things. And so security also for you as investor, as user, and so on. We have to provide more security than other coin and or so on. And maybe you will be.
This will come with the change, of course. As me and Julian are working on it, this will come with the change. We're gonna do some changes on the confirmations and stuff like that to keep the network more secure. What really is more important than anything else at this point for me and for the team is to keep everybody found safe. So that is the main goal. So you gotta be thinking that we are going to implement a lot of stuff to make Peril Network the safest one, or if not the safest one, as safe as we can.
Yeah, because I think currently we simulate an attack, but not a 51, but I think it's more like a 71 percent. So even with 20% of the net hash rate, you are not able to attack the main net. And also, you have to mine, for example, more than 2,000 blocks to be able to change something.
Just for the guys who are not aware, usually for a 51, you would have to do 20 blocks. And now you need to do 2,000 blocks to maybe be able to do something.
Oh, also want to talk about the tournament as well.
Yeah, let's do it, baby.
Well, for those of you that don't know, we are going to be having our second PUBG charity tournament in association with StackUp.org, which is a veterans charity. There's prizes for the top three participants, and there is no entry fee. All that is required is that you have a Steam and a PC copy of PUBG. And the sign-up form has been put in, should have been a link to it, should have been put in the blog post about it, and it's also on the Peril official Twitter. I also RT'd it as well. So anyway, yeah, go to the Peril official Twitter and you guys can find the sign up sheet there. It will be held on November 11th, so about 3 weeks.
Yeah, so
I must start warming up. Who wants to warm up with me?
No. I just want to say Peril team can participate, but you are not allowed to win. Okay, so if you win, you will lose.
If there is four people left, you don't kill anyone. You let them kill you.
Well, Mickey, if your Twitter's suspended, I'm pretty sure you can find it in the blog post.
Yeah.
Yeah, the one you wrote.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm saying. And if it's not there, he has only himself to blame.
Okay, guys. Thank you. It's been great, great meeting. Very happy to have our guest here, and very happy to see the new version of PyroTube coming out. Some services. It's been a nice week, and I'm happy that even through through hard times, we keep on our feet and keep progressing. So thanks everyone for joining in. If there is no more questions.
Thank you everyone for joining in. Thank our guest to be there and to present the project.
Thank you, Rodrigo. We'll be looking forward to see your project.
Thank you for our new dev that's coming in, and marketing guys, and every people that contributed to the project. So don't forget to check PillTube, to check the status website, so you don't have to ask again and again in general if Poseidon is down or up. And check the docs. You will have the new docs for the PillTube there with the changelog, so you can check the fix. And I think it's pretty everything. Have a nice weekend.
And see you later, guys.
See you guys.
Don't forget to go on PUBG tournament.
Yeah, have a nice weekend. Thank you for participating. Nice.
Mickey, just try to fix your Twitter first so you can read your article.
Yeah, I need to write down like my promise written in the blood that I will not attempt to sell any more efforts. By the Twitter.
All right, thanks everybody. See you later, Grodigy.
Hey, see you later, guys.
Bye guys.
Good job.